Hello everybody, it's me, Andrew, and this is going to be your weekly reading for May 9th through the 15th. So I'm using a deck I haven't worked with in a while, which is like the majority of my decks. and it is the Ascended Masters Oracle cards. So that's, and it's by Dorian Virtue. So we're going to see what they have for us. Whoa. That card will be, that'll be for Monday, Tuesday. That just flew out, so. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Friday, Saturday, Sunday. And two bonus cards. Do I have two bonus cards? All right. Hell yeah. So for Monday and Tuesday, we have a flow of prosperity. So, like, can I get an amen? Like, amen. Yeah. So this is pretty much self-explanatory, but I want to go into a little bit more detail with it because this isn't necessarily saying that you are going to run into huge amounts of money. What this is saying is that there is a flow of prosperity that will be heightened during this time. And we are in the new moon now, so it's a time to release things that no longer serve us. And so it's time for you to ask yourself, what is keeping you from being in that flow of prosperity? What is keeping you, and this is for me too, what is keeping me, what is keeping us from being in that constant flow of prosperity where we are moving with the universe and the ebbs and flows of the universe, and we're constantly receiving that prosperity that we need? There's going to be a lot of prosperity energy on Monday and Tuesday. This is the goddess Lakshmi from Hinduism. So I really like her. She's amazing. So you can also ask her to help you with identifying any blocks to prosperity. But I would start doing this now because we want to be ready for Monday and Tuesday. So you're watching this on a Sunday, ask that question of her today and see what she says. So that way you can fully embrace the prosperity that's coming on Monday and Tuesday. Oh, this is pretty neat. Priorities. Priorities comes up. This is King Solomon. So this is saying that there's two things. The first thing is that say no to anything that is not a priority for you at this time. So if something isn't a priority for you and someone's asking you to do something, and kitty, and someone's asking you to do something, and it doesn't quite align with you and it's not really part of something that you thought you should do, say no to. This is also saying to not BS and not, you know, just mess around and not get stuff done. It's saying to remember that you have priorities in taking care of yourself physically, spiritually, emotionally, and mentally. So really kind of, and if you're kind of like me, like I have a hard time with like to-do lists, because I forget to do the to-do list. But this is saying, if that's something that helps you, make a list. You know, really kind of start getting stuff done, and you'll notice a lot of changes and a lot of positive things coming your way when you start acknowledging your priorities and going that route. So the card for the weekend is Listen, and this is Manjushri, I'm not sure. But it's Listen. So it kind of feels like, because normally I feel like it would be listen, like follow your priorities and like get your priorities in order and then you'll be in the flow of prosperity. But what this is saying is it's actually kind of going in the reverse. Acknowledge that you're in that flow of prosperity and make a list of priorities, things that you need to do, things that you have to do. And some of them may not be fun, some of them might be fun, and you might be able to find ways to make other things more fun to do. But when we acknowledge the tasks, I guess, that we have to do in the physical world, heaven acknowledges that too. And because, you know, sometimes we like to forsake the physical stuff for the spiritual stuff. And, you know, we are spiritual beings having a human experience. So the human experience is very vital to us. And so that is something that we need to embrace and live to the fullest. Now, when it comes to listen, what they're saying is you have to listen closely because there's going to be a lot of guidance coming at the end of the week. And I feel like, and so what they just showed me is a circle. So what they're saying is that once you begin to listen more, you'll be able to recognize those priorities more, and you'll be put in that flow of prosperity more. So that's what it's saying. So it's not necessarily saying that you should just be listening for guidance all the time. It's really saying that when you listen to it, your priorities become clear. And when you make listening a priority, you'll know how to put yourself in that flow of abundance. Nice. Okay. So for the two bonus cards that came up, we have positive change and retreat into nature with the green man and Parvati. So these two cards just come up as, you know, little bonus ones, but it's saying that there is a lot of obvious positive change coming your way. And it all hinges on you listening to the guidance that you get. You can't not listen to guidance and expect positive change. It doesn't work like that. Even if the change is hard, you have to know that it's for the best. And the best way to listen is to be in nature. And the cash is on the table. And if you have nature around you, or if you have a place to go where, you know, you feel comfortable, nature is the best. The weather's getting warmer, at least here on the East Coast. It's really nice. But it's also, you know, it's just saying, hey, you know, you can ask the fairies for help. You can ask the green man for help. He's like the male counterpart to Mother Nature. So that's where you'll be able to find a lot of these this guidance from. Now, if you can't go into nature, if you're not around nature, then you can just ask the fairies to come in and to help you and to give you guidance. And they will definitely do it. And they'll be cheeky little people when you do. But that's your reading for the week. So just remember that the flow of prosperity, that prosperity is always flowing. It's a constant rhythm and circle that you're either in tune with or out of tune with. And it's one of those things that you need to make sure that you are in tune with, because prosperity is very important. You know, while we feel scared to have money, money is like integral for us to, especially for people who are very spiritual and who want to share their message, money is integral to paying our bills. It's, you know, we use money to share our messages, to, you know, whatever we do. So it's very important. So don't feel bad for asking for money, because asking for help is a really big part of it too. So just ask to constantly remain in that flow of abundance, and I think that you will be pleasantly surprised when you do. So big announcement that I think I said I was going to announce this week, but I'm not sure if I did or not, but I'm announcing it this week anyway. I am teaching a tarot course at the Tarot Readers Academy Tarot Summer School, and it is hosted by the wonderful and lovely and amazing Ethany. And if you can find information on that at ethany.com, I'll put the link below. It's me and it's a ton of amazing tarot people who are just like badasses in their own right. Like, I know Bridget Esselmont, Benabel Wynn, those are just two of the names that are teaching some amazing tarot courses. My course will be on angels in tarot. It will be how to bring the angels into a traditional tarot reading. Because it's true that sometimes people don't necessarily identify with angel cards as a whole. And while a lot of people do, a lot of people don't. And so I want to share with people how, even though I do identify with angel cards very much, how I have used tarot cards in my practice and brought the angels into that. So I really want people to get the full benefit of angels in tarot for themselves and for their clients. So that's my course. Each course is $25, $24, sorry. Each course is $24, and a whole season pass for the whole course is $199. So you can definitely check that out. I'll put her website below. And my course will be launching September 6th. So you still have a little bit to wait for it, but the other courses will be launching kind of as it goes. I think it starts in, you can start registering it in June. You can start registering for summer, Tarot Summer School June 1st. So that is it. If you would like a reading with me, you can check out the links below. You can sign up for my email list. You get a 30% off coupon for anything that I offer on my shop, on my website. And you get a free PDF that I made about the angels. So go check that out. And I will be seeing you guys soon. Angel blessings. Bye.